Hello everyone. In the last presentation of stereochemistry, we will discuss this. What are isomers? Then types of isomers and details of constitutional isomers only. In this presentation, we will continue with this and other types of isomers. The first one is stereoisomers. These isomers are nothing but the same molecular formula and different structural formula. But in this case of stereoisomerism, the atoms are jointed to each other in the different spatial arrangement. They occupy a different position in three-dimensional space. These are called as the stereoisomers. These are two types, geometrical isomers and optical isomers. First one is geometrical isomers. These are nothing but found in some but not in alkenes. There is a restriction in a rotation of carbon-carbon double bonds to get to these forms. Two forms are there, one is cis and another one is trans geometrical isomers. So what do you mean by cis? Cis is nothing but a group or atoms are on the same side of the carbon-carbon double bond. Means same groups are on the same side of the carbon-carbon double bond. These are called as cis isomers. And trans means the same or identical groups on the opposite side of the carbon-carbon double bond. These are called as the trans isomers. These cis and trans isomers having a different physical properties like boiling points and density, but have a similar chemical properties in most of the cases. So again, this second one is geometrical isomerism in alkenes, that E and Z or cis and trans isomerism. When cis and trans, if the compound or carbons are not substituted with the similar groups, these carbons are substituted with the different groups in their structure. So E and Z isomerism is applicable for this. The carbon-carbon double bond, if the same groups are not present on the different carbon atoms, if the four groups are different, so E and Z nomenclature is applicable for this. So first one is Z isomer. So Z is nothing but a zeusamine, means the highest priority groups or atoms on the same side of the carbon-carbon double bond. And if the highest priority groups or atoms on the opposite side of the carbon-carbon double bond, these are called as E isomers. To determine the priority, the CIP rules are applicable. That is, conventional rules is used. Means this, for example, in case of this two carbons is greater highest priority than CH3 than hydrogen, and in case of this like iodine, bromine, as per its atomic mass number, the hydrogen is least priority. So in this case, if this one is considered, so Z means on the same side and E means the opposite side, means the highest priority group is on the same side, like this highest priority group is on the same side. These two are highest priority. Out of this one, this one is two, this one is one, this one is two. These are the highest priority group, means highest priority group is on the same side, so it is called as a Z isomer. And if the highest priority group is on the opposite side, it is called as a E isomer, it is called as a integer. So geometrical isomerism same should only be used when there are two hydrogens and two non-hydrogen groups attached to each other. So cis non-hydrogen groups or terms on the same side of the carbon-carbon double bond is called as a cis, and trans means is the opposite one. This is called as cis, means the same side, this is on the opposite side. This one is the cis again, this one is the trans again. The cis hands means thumbs figure, for example, these are on the same side of the, and these are on the opposite side, so this is called as a trans isomer. So optical isomerism, and optical activity is nothing but the substances rotates the plane polarized light. This is the concept is called as optical activity, which is derived by Biot scientist in 1815. The plane polarized light is light has been passed through an equal prism or other polarizing medium so that all the vibrations are on the same plane. These are the polarized light on the same plane. These are the non-polarized light on the different planes. This dextrorotary is nothing but when the plane polarized light is rotated in clockwise direction when viewed through a polarimeter. It is denoted by dextrorotary in the small d and sign is positive sign. Do not confuse with the d. This d and l is different nomenclature for carbohydrates. This Liu rotatory means the plane of polarized light is rotated towards the left hand side or rotated in a counter clockwise means anti-clockwise direction when viewed through a polarimeter. This is called as a L isomer. It is small l and denoted by negative sign. The angle of rotation of plane polarized light by an optically active substance is proportional to the number of atoms in the path of light. Then light restricted to pass through a plane is polarized light. Polarimeter is nothing but instrument that measures the rotation of plane polarized light that has passed through a solution. Clockwise means dextrorotary, anticlockwise means Liu rotatory. This plane polarized light that passed through a solution of chiral compound remains in the plane is optically inactive. Solutions of chiral compounds rotate the plane polarized light and molecules are said to be optically active. When this ordinary light is passing through an equal prism, this is a polarized light, this is a sample cube and it rotates either on the left hand side or right hand side. This observer, this analyzer is there. This is the instrumental of polarimeter. Next one is optical isomerism. Chiral center first. What is meant by chiral centers? The center having a four different groups attached with the four different groups or atoms like red, blue, green and yellow. There are four different colors arranged tetrahedrally about the carbon atom. This is called as a chiral center or chiral carbon. If an object has a plane of symmetry, it's the same as its mirror image. The plane of symmetry divides an entire molecule into two pieces that are exact mirror image. A chiral means that the object has a plane of symmetry. Molecules that are not superimposable with their mirror images are called as chiral, that is handlessness. Hands gloves are prime example of the chiral object. They have a left and right version. Organic molecules are chiral or achiral in nature. If it is a chiral and a chiral molecule, some molecules are like hands. Left and right hands are mirror images of each other, but they are not identical or non-superimposable. These are non-superimposable. These are not superimposable and not identical. But these are the mirror images of each other. Means this hand is considered as a chiral one. A molecule or object that are not superimposable on its mirror image is said to have a chiral compounds. The chiral lattice center, carbon has a four different groups are attached. This is a four different groups, but these are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. These are called as chiral centers. A point in a molecule where four different groups or atoms are attached to a carbon is called as a chiral center. A chiral molecule usually has at least one chiral center. For example, if we consider this bromodecane, it is a chiral, 5-bromodecane. This carbon is considered as a chiral because this is substituted with this bromo first, then hydrogen, then 1, 2, 3, 4, it is butane, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is pentane. So butyl, pentyl and bromo and hydrogen, these are the 5 different substituents on this carbon atom. So this carbon is considered as a chiral center or chiral carbon. So configurational isomers, the arrangement in a space of four different groups about a chiral center. means arrangement of four different groups about a chiral center is called as configuration. So how do we show configurations? The first is Wedge formula. This is the Wedge formula. This carbon is substituted with this one hydrogen, this chlorine, fluoro and bromine. So when we are converting this into a Fischer projection is a cross structure at like a plus sign. It has Wedge is on the left hand side, then dotted is on the right hand side, and bromo is on the plane, that is in the plane. So this is conversion of Wedge formula into Fischer projection formula. So Fischer used the term DNL to label the two molecules first. Drawing a stereogenic center, the Fischer projection, in Fischer projection of chiral compounds or carbon, it's mirror image. So horizontal bonds project towards the viewer and vertical bonds projects away from the viewer. The test for non-super imposability into a slide, one on top of the other and rotate 180 degree and attempt the same. The Fischer projection of the two enantiomers of 2-butanol. This is a 2-butanol. This OH is on the right hand side. This OH is on the left hand side. These are the mirror images of each other, but these are non-superimposable. When we place this molecule, this butanol on this, the OH is on the OH and the H is on the OH. So these are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. The chiral carbon atom is at the center of cross line. So enantiomers, these are called as enantiomers, non-superimposable mirror images of each other, called as enantiomers. This is a mirror image, this one is mirror image, this is lactic acid, S and R configuration. This is R enantiomers binding site, this is S enantiomer binding sites. These is not fitted into this, that's why this is required for the binding purpose. This R enantiomer is biologically active on this thalidomide is example of this. This is a sedative hypnotic. Activity shows when this thalidomide is in a R or dextrorotary. When thalidomide is in the S form, it shows a teratogenic effect. So for this purpose, this R and S configuration is required, means for biological activity. When the compound having this R configuration, then only it shows biological activity as a sedative and hypnotic, not this teratogen. Though stereochemistry of this means R and S nomenclature, since the enantiomers are two different compounds, they need to distinguish by name. This is done by adding the prefix called RNS, IUPAC name of the enantiomer. Naming the enantiomers with the prefix R or S is called as CHNCIP rule, that is Kahn, Ingold and Prelog system. To designate the enantiomers as R and S, priorities must be assigned to each group bonded to the stereogenic center in order to decreasing atomic number. The highest is the atomic weight, first is the priority. On that basis, the atom of highest atomic number gets highest priority, means highest is the atomic weight or atomic number gets first priority or highest priority. In this case, the first priority goes to this bromine, second priority goes to this chlorine, third one is fluorine, and fourth one is this hydrogen, having the least priority out of this four groups attached to the chiral center or chiral carbon. So this absolute configuration, use this CIP rule, priorities, place the lowest priority group back, focus on carbon 4 bond, draw arrow like 1, 2, 3 and 4, like 1, 2, 3 anticlockwise. It is lactic acid S and R lactic acid. sequence rule for specification of configuration. In general, method applied to determining the configuration at each chiral center instead of whole molecule. Configuration is specified by the relative position of all the groups with respect to each other at chiral center. So methods are for assigning this RNS configuration. Assign each group priority 1 to 4 according to CIP rule. Rotate the assigned molecule until the lowest priority group is in the back. Look at the remaining 3 groups in the plane. If it rotates the clockwise, the designated as R, it is Latin term, it is rectus, it is the right hand side, and sinister counterclockwise is S, is called as sinister, the Latin word is left. So priority is assigned to each substituent on the chiral carbon. Rotate the structure so that the lowest priority towards the rear. Draw an arc from the highest to next lower to the next lower. Then if arc is clockwise, then R configuration. If arrangement is counterclockwise, it is S configuration, like this. This is if rotate this, if you rotate this clockwise, so this one is clockwise, so it is R configuration. So priority rule, look at the atoms directly attached to the chiral carbon and assign the priority based on the atomic number. If decision can't be reached by ranking the first atom in the substituent, look at the second, third, fourth atom until difference is found. Multiple bond atoms are equivalent to the same number of single bonds. So labeling of this example of each enantiomer RNS, these are the examples. So these are the mirror images of each other again, but non-superimposable. So the priority is the group around zero ring center, 2-butanol. So it is first highest priority, second one, third, and lowest priority, fourth, as per decreasing order or CIP rule. This is again a place 2, second step 2. Orient the molecule with lowest priority 4 back on dash and visualize the relative position of the remaining groups. That is 1, 2, 3. It is 1, 2, 3. It is what? 1, 2, 3. It is clockwise. So it is R isomer, like this, clockwise, and if it is counterclockwise, it is S isomer. Again an example, continue. Next one is what is meant by racemic mixture. So racemic mixture is the amount of two enantiomer, equal amount of two enantiomer is called as racemic mixture or racemate. Racemic mixture is optically inactive because the enantiomers rotates the plane polarized light to an equal extent, but the opposite direction the reaction cancels and no rotation is observed. It is melting point, boiling point, and optical rotation of A alone, identical to B, identical to A, may be different from A and B, that the racemic mixture. These are the properties of racemic mixture. So specific rotation is nothing but standardized physical constant for the amount that chiral compound rotates plane polarized light. Specific rotation is denoted by the symbol sigma and defined using a specific sample tube length, that is gram per milliliter, temperature, and wavelength is. Molecules with the more than one chiral centers have mirror images, stereomers, stereoisomers, that are enantiomers. In addition, they have a stereoisomeric form that are not mirror images, called as diastereomers. Enantiomers are different and diastereomers are different. Enantiomers are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. Diastereomers are similar, but they mirror image. Enantiomers are opposite configuration at all chiral centers. Diastereomers are opposite at the same. Diastereomers have different physical properties. Epimers are diastereomers different at only one chiral center. These are the stereoisomers that are not mirror images, called as diastereomers. Means enantiomers are mirror images and diastereomers are not mirror images. Still, this carbon is chiral in nature. This is the examples of tartaric acid, superimposable. This is meso compound. Meso compound means when plane of plane of symmetry is passing through the molecule, the first half is the mirror image of second one or below one. This is superimposable. This is called as the meso compound. This is regarding whole stereochemistry and types of isomers, classification of isomers, stereoisomers, optical isomers, geometrical isomers, etc. Thank you.